Let's begin our discussion of the anterior thorax, or the osteology of the anterior thorax, with your sternum or your breastbone. But before we get into the actual structures of the bone, let's talk about where you can actually locate it on your body. So on the inferior portion of your neck right here, you should feel this divot right here. Where this is going to match up on the bone is right here, your jugular notch or your suprasternal notch. And then on either side of the sternum, you can see these smooth divots as well. Anytime you have smooth areas on the bone, you know that that means a joint is there. So your sternoclavicular joints, and you can feel your clavicles on either side, are going to articulate right here. So get a good indication of what we're talking about, and let's talk about the three main parts of the bone. Now, most superiorly, you're going to have your manubrium, which means the handle. Intermediate, you'll have the body. And then the most inferior portion is your xiphoid process. And the xiphoid process on each individual is variable. It'll look different on every individual. So in this particular one, you see it's kind of a little bit smaller than the body right here. So as we discussed, the jugular notches right here, your clavicular notches. And then if we look at a lateral view, you can see all these divots in the bone. This is actually where your ribs are articulating with the sternum. So as the anterior portions of the ribs come around, you'll have costal cartilages, which will expand all the way to the sternum, and you can have these creations of these divots right here. So recall that we have 12 ribs. Only 10 are actually going to articulate with the sternum via the costal cartilages. Now this inferior-most portion right here in younger individuals are actually not going to be articulated. It can actually be separated by cartilage, but with age, as in most bones, you're going to have the fusion of the bone with the body right here. Now this is actually going to extend fairly far in terms of the thorax. You're going to be about at the level of the inferior heart or the superior portion of the liver. So we'll continue our discussion of the anterior thorax with the ribs.